Well, as we can see that Prime Minister Modi has now reached and he's kick-starting his day two in the India-Nepal State Summit. Now, in a clear sign that relations with Nepal had whole importance for India, Prime Minister Narendra Modi is visiting the neighboring country for the third time in 4 years. Now, it is the first high-level visit from India since the formation of a new government in Nepal this year, and hence it holds strategic importance. Now, the visit is seen as an attempt by both countries to bring back normalcy in their ties after a spell of uneasiness. And it's particularly important in the backdrop of the strengthening of its political and economic ties. Now, for Nepal, Modi's visit shortly comes after the formation of the strong leftist government led by Nepalese Prime Minister Oli, and it is being seen as India's endorsement of Nepalese constitution that was promulgated 2.5 years ago. Now, we are getting you all the live updates from day two of Prime Minister Modi's Nepal visit. Prime Minister Modi has reached Muktinath Temple, starting his day two in the Nepal-India summit. Now, this summit has a lot of importance considering that it comes at a very strategic point. It's a sign that relations with Nepal hold importance for India, and Prime Minister Narendra Modi is visiting the neighboring country upholding the neighborhood first policy, and which is why this is the third time in 4 years that this high level visit is happening between the two countries. Now, the visit is seen as an attempt in strengthening ties between the two countries. The focus of this meet remains strengthening the infrastructure and development between the two countries. Now, let us take you through some of the developments that happened on day one of the meet. Prime Minister Modi and Nepali Prime Minister Oli lay the foundation stone for the construction of 900 Arun 3 project. And right now, for more updates, we have with us Siddhant Sibyl joining us live from Kathmandu. Siddhant, tell us, what updates do you have as of now?
Well, the Indian Prime Minister has reached Muktinath. Today is the second day of his two-day Nepal visit, and he just landed shortly about 10 minutes ago in Muktinath. This is a important place and a place of significance for both Hindus and Buddhists. And if we look at his two-day visit schedule, it's majorly about temples. It's about religious symbolism and basically faith diplomacy at its best. Yesterday we saw the Indian Prime Minister starting his visit from Janakpur, where he flagged off that bus service connecting Janakpur with Ayodhya, and both the cities were connected with this bus service. It's very important and symbolic because both the cities are birthplaces of Hindu gods. And today, right now, as we speak, the Indian Prime Minister is in Muktinath, and we can see those visuals of Muktinath. It's a very old ancient temple and a temple of historic significance for Hindus and Buddhists. And Prime Minister is going to stay for a few hours, I believe 1.5 hours, and then Prime Minister leaves back to Kathmandu, where I am standing, and he will be visiting Pashupatinath Temple. His second visit to Pashupatinath Temple, during his first visit in 2014, he visited Pashupatinath, and again this time around when he's visiting that famous temple here. in Kathmandu. This is an important place because Pashupatinath is one of the char dhams, and a lot of Indian pilgrims come. Yesterday when the Prime Minister of India was speaking and the Prime Minister of Nepal was speaking, they talked about the fact that it will increase tourism. But now you can see visuals of the Indian Prime Minister taking that pilgrimage to that famous temple Muktinath, which is quite historic and ancient. Yesterday during the press statements also, the Prime Minister of Nepal lauded this visit to Muktinath and said that it's for the first time that any foreign head of state has visited this this place, this this historic place of significance for Hindus and Buddhists. So the Prime Minister of India taking darshan, and these visuals resemble those visuals from Janakpur, where the Indian Prime Minister we saw that did puja. And these visuals show the connect between Nepal and India, common heritage, common culture, faith. As the Prime Minister of India said that India and Nepal are connected to faith from Kanyakumari to Kathmandu. There is one faith, and India is not complete without Nepal, because Nepal has a lot of places of Hindu religion where a lot of pilgrims from India come regularly. A lot of places from Nepal, from Nepal, people come to Nepal, to India to visit the places of significance. But in Pashupatinath, remember that Prime Minister, this second visit, and the main priest of Pashupatinath is from southern India. This time, of course, he is in he is from Bangalore, and that's important given the fact that state today votes.
Exactly. Precisely what I was coming to, Siddhant, that this religious diplomacy is not just limited to Nepal. It's also, you know, it also comes back to India, because today, is this just a mere coincidence that Karnataka is voting today, and it's coming at the heels of a poll-bound Karnataka? The religious diplomacy is, it's very evident.
Well, there are two parts of this. First, of course, the global audience, the international affairs, connecting Nepal with India through religious symbolism, through faith. And of course, the second part, as you mentioned, Karnataka is going to vote today, and it of course will help the audience there, the constituency there, the BJP constituency, people who are expected to go for voting. These visuals matter, and of course yesterday we saw that symbolism connecting the two cities of birth, both the places, birthplaces of Hindu gods. So clearly important for domestic constituencies as well as for the global international affairs. And you can see the Indian Prime Minister being welcomed in a traditional manner at the Muktinath Temple.
Right.
By people there, by the people who the local people there.
Siddhant, we can see these live visuals coming in of Prime Minister Narendra Modi being greeted by all the local Nepalese people over there who have, of course, thronged the Muktinath Temple. It's very important for you to establish the historical significance and the cultural significance of Muktinath Temple, and why the Prime Minister has chosen to keep it as part of his itinerary, because yesterday he was at Janakpur and today he will also be visiting Pashupatinath Temple, which is a world famous temple. And what is the relevance of Muktinath? Let's talk about that, Siddhant.
Well, Muktinath is a Vishnu temple, and it's very ironic that the Prime Minister started his visit by going to a Ram temple. Then he visited, right now he's in Muktinath, which is a Vishnu temple, and then finally he'll come to Pashupatinath, which is a Shiva temple. Now, these three complete the Holy Trinity in Hinduism, and that matters a lot in symbolic terms, because the Prime Minister has visited the Creator, the Destroyer, and the God who regenerates everything. So clearly, that is the underlying significance of his visit. It is full of religious symbolism. Symbolism, of course, matters when relationships are special, and Nepal-India relationship are considered to be very, very special. And this visit is expected to make it more special, considering the fact that this is the third visit of the Indian Prime Minister. to Nepal, and the Prime Minister of India, Narendra Modi, hasn't been gone to any South Asian countries so many times. He has been to Nepal 3 times, that's maximum for any South Asian countries. So that shows that growing closeness, at least at the political level now, because last few years haven't been good for India-Nepal ties, especially after the blockade. And this trip is all about making up to that. And we know that on the ground, the common people are actually not really happy because the blockade really did made their life worse, especially coming after that massive earthquake. But of course, India is trying its best. Yesterday, we saw Prime Minister Narendra Modi speaking about so many things. He said that Buddha was
going
born in Lumbini.
That is something the common man here in Nepal going to
really take it positively.
Right. I'm just coming to that because, you know, it's very important to speak about how Prime Minister Narendra Modi's visit is aimed at healing old wounds and building trust between India and Nepal. It was at Janakpur yesterday that in his speech, clearly he was reassuring Nepal that India will always be by the side of Nepal. And there was also a camouflaged warning for Nepal in terms when he said that we must choose our neighbors carefully. So we clearly know that he was hinting at China's presence in Nepal. So, you know, how would you analyze the PM's speech in Janakpur yesterday?
Well, Prime Minister's speech in Janakpur was a heart-to-heart meeting with not the political class, but the common man of Nepal. It was all about telling the common man that India will always be there in their best, of course, but in their worst also. And the focus was on how faith is the cornerstone, the pillar, the foundation of India-Nepal ties. He, of course, spoke on many things. He spoke about the political process in Nepal. He has spoken twice yesterday on the political process, first at Janakpur and then of course at the press statements with the Prime Minister of Nepal. In Janakpur he said that Nepal chose ballot over bullet, Buddha over Yudh. So that is the focus. So clearly he chose his words carefully to talk to the common man of Nepal, who is really not happy with India. There has been a trust deficit, and that trust deficit has been completed by China. China has now a number of connectivity projects. China has even said that it's open to a connectivity projects from India, from China, Nepal and India, a three-way connectivity project. But that, of course, is something that India is not agreeable to. India has said that rather it will continue with its own connectivity things and connectivity ways with Nepal. Remember, India and Nepal has a long porous border, which has been emphasized yesterday also by the Prime Minister during the press statements. Now, if we have this connectivity process or path, Chinese goods can flood the Indian market. That is something India is fearful of. But today it's all about fair diplomacy. The visuals are on your screen.
Right.
The Prime Minister of India being welcomed at that famous Muktinath Temple, a temple of significance for both Hindus and Buddhist.
Right, we can see these live visuals coming in from Muktinath Temple in Nepal, where Prime Minister Narendra Modi is gracing the red carpet to the temple. And it was just a few minutes ago that we saw the Prime Minister being welcomed by the Nepalese people over there. And many have thronged the temple just to catch a glimpse of the Indian Prime Minister. As we all know, it's a two-day tight scheduled visit for the Prime Minister to Nepal, and it will be in the evening that Prime Minister Narendra Modi will leave back for India. And clearly, faith or religious diplomacy has played an important role in facilitating India-Nepal ties. And clearly seems like a new chapter for the two countries. It was yesterday at Janakpur that Prime Minister Narendra Modi reassured Nepal of its presence. He also mentioned that India and Nepal must forge better connectivity, and that Nepal figures prominently in India's neighborhood policy.
These are live visuals coming in from Nepal's Muktinath Temple, where Prime Minister Narendra Modi of India is being greeted by the local people who have thronged the temple. And let's quickly go back to our correspondent Siddhant Sibal, who's reporting live from Kathmandu. Siddhant, clearly religious diplomacy has helped tremendously to facilitate better ties between India and Nepal, and we can see Prime Minister Modi is at the Muktinath Temple. What follows after this temple visit today?
Well, after this temple visit, he comes back to Kathmandu, where he will be going to Pashupatinath Temple, as I have already mentioned. This is his second visit to Pashupatinath Temple. Then, of course, he meets political leaders here. And after that, there will be a big civic reception. Why that civic reception matters? Because this is the second civic reception in Nepal in 2 days. First was in Janakpur. And we can see some parallels between both the civic receptions. The Prime Minister of India speaking his heart out to the common people of Nepal. The mayor of Kathmandu will also be there, and of course the other political leadership will be there. And focus, of course, will be on many things, as always, on how India and Nepal have close ties, what the Prime Minister said yesterday. And important thing will be on the faith diplomacy, which we are seeing as of now, as the visit is underway. The Prime Minister, of course, focusing on many things as well, like Nepal is no longer a land locked country, it's a land link and water link country. That is one of the headlines in one of the Nepali newspapers, which show that the media at least here is taking it in a positive manner. Other than that, the focus will be by and large on how to build back that trust, how to change that perception, because what is working against India here in Nepal is India is considered as pushing its own radical agenda in the country, while China is considered as a country that is willing to work in the sovereign system of Nepal, even though there has been an increased Chinese presence, and Chinese track record in South Asia at least is not good. We saw what happened in Sri Lanka, where they had to lease an entire port. The Chinese presence is increasing in Bangladesh as well. And we know about Pakistan. They have all-weather friendship higher than the K2 and deeper than Gwadar. But focusing on what is going to happen in Nepal, China's long shadow remains here. And of course, that will be the elephant in the relationship between India and Nepal. There's a growing Chinese presence on the ground here in Kathmandu. We go around Kathmandu, you can see a lot of Chinese signboards, currency changers, a lot of Chinese tourists. That is something that shows increased physical presence of Chinese. Right. But today, as we speak, the Prime Minister of India at Muktinath, religious symbolism being the focus and faith diplomacy at its best.
Right. You mentioned that, you know, there is growing Chinese presence, especially very, very prominent in Kathmandu. And yesterday, the Prime Minister was in Kathmandu and a lot of important strategic decisions were taken during his meeting with Nepal Prime Minister Oli. Run us through what bilateral decisions have the two countries arrived upon in Kathmandu.
Well, the big focus was on connectivity not only through rail, but through water and air. Other than that, the Prime Minister of Nepal talked about demonetization. He said that it's time that the demonetized currency, which is being left unused here. I mean, you can't use now demonetization, the currency, either in Nepal or, of course, in India. So that is a contentious issue because Nepalis also suffered majorly due to demonetization. Other than that, the focus was on infrastructure. We saw both the Prime Ministers inaugurating that Arun 3 project, the largest infrastructure project here in Nepal, and the Prime Minister of India said that it will create more economic opportunities for the people of Nepal. Focus also on things like agriculture. Both the agriculture ministers of India and Nepal will be meeting soon. That was announced yesterday, and a date was provided that by September 19, that is the Constitution Day of Nepal, all the contentious issues that have been bogging both the sides, India and Nepal, will be sort out. Other big issue was flooding, because a lot of areas in the Tarai region in southern Nepal gets inundated during the flood season because of dam builds in India. That was something that the Prime Minister of Nepal openly talked about and said that something has to be done, on which it was decided that a joint team will go to areas which get inundated regularly during the flood season. lot of decision on things like energy, because India is going to build transmission lines across Nepal. Power trading was discussed during the meeting. Other than that, culture, faith, people-to-people contact, these are things which, of course, are discussed in every meet, every bilateral meet. So these are the gist of things which were discussed. And in Janakpur, if you recall, the Prime Minister announced a massive program, a grant for development of Janakpur and the surrounding area. That, of course, will help in India's image boost, at least in the region. But by and large, it was all about a faith diplomacy that helps Nepal, because India has been providing a lot of development assistance to Nepal. Remember, after the earthquake struck Nepal, India was the first country to send relief and rescue missions. And the Prime Minister of Nepal yesterday even thanked publicly for India's this grand gesture and said that India will always be your friend. Both the countries, remember, are natural allies. They have been allies since many years. The Prime Minister of India himself said that India and Nepal share ties since the Vedas were there. So that shows the common heritage, common linkages between both the countries. Though relationship between Kathmandu and New Delhi might be going up or down, it's the people-to-people contact that sustains this relationship. And as you can see on on your television screens, those visuals, this temple, this visit might be, in a sense, a part of Prime Minister's schedule. But these images will be remembered by the people of India and by the people of Nepal forever, because it shows the common linkages between India and Nepal.
Right. This is indeed a very, very integral visit for Prime Minister Narendra Modi, because let's not forget that even though he's visited Nepal earlier, this is the first time he's visiting Nepal since the new government was formed in Nepal. But coming back to the India-Nepal ties, Sudhan, don't you think that yesterday's speech by Prime Minister Narendra Modi in Janakpur was more of a confidence-building exercise from his end for Nepal? Because there's lots for India to actually materialize on when it comes to its promises. Because we know that last month when Prime Minister Oli was in India, Nepal Prime Minister was in India, he wanted that, you know, all the projects that have been taken up so far have not been really materialized. Don't you think that that is the challenge that Prime Minister Narendra Modi of India faces, to actually materialize projects that they actually embark upon?
Well, usually when leaders meet, they sign an MOU for development, for assistance, especially when it comes to India and Nepal. But this time, no agreements were signed, no new projects were announced. The Prime Minister of Nepal had a meeting with the former Prime Ministers of Nepal, and everyone came to this conclusion that till the time that previous projects are not completed, they are not going to announce or go for new project announcements, because that is something that that are never completed. The Nepali media was full of visuals, pictures on how previous projects were not completed and no new projects. There's no point of having no new projects. Ironically, only a month ago, the Prime Minister of Nepal was in New Delhi, and the similar thing happened. No new projects were announced, only the fact that previous projects need to be announced. And India faces this issue. India announces, promises, but it's not able to deliver. Unlike China, who not only promises, finishes the projects earlier than the time. Earlier than the deadline. So that is something India has to work on delivering on its promises.
Right. Let me also inform all our viewers who are tuning in that Prime Minister Narendra Modi is in Nepal's Muktinath Temple, where he's being greeted by the priests and monks at the Muktinath Temple. These are live visuals being streamed from Muktinath. As we all know, this is a part of his tightly packed two-day visit to Nepal. And it will be in the evening today that Prime Minister Modi will head back to India. Let's go back to our correspondent Sidhant Sibal, who's joining us live from Kathmandu. Sidhant, we were just discussing how the biggest challenge at the moment for India and for Prime Minister Modi is to actually materialize those projects. And isn't that an area where China actually beats India, because they've managed to deliver projects unlike India?
Well, China has deep pockets. It's not only Nepal. It's showing its presence all over the world, and especially in South Asia. South Asia was once considered the backyard of India. No longer it's true, because China has presence in Maldives, in Sri Lanka, Bangladesh, and I would rather not say about Pakistan, because they are already friends. But this is something that worries India. There is anxiety in New Delhi about it, growing closeness between Kathmandu and Beijing. And remember, Nepal is part of the OBOR, One Belt, One Road initiative. That's the flagship connectivity program of India, of China. But what differentiates India and China's connectivity project is the fact that Chinese
View the visuals. We can see Prime Minister Narendra Modi has entered the holy abode of the Muktinath Temple, and he's offering his prayers. He also met the priests inside this abode. As we can see, he is offering his prayers. All right, let's also go back to Siddhant. Siddhant, we were talking about how China is a challenge for India in terms of its ties with Nepal. Please continue.
Well, we know about this issue, Chinese growing presence. But let me tell you a small nugget of fact, that right now on your screen, what you can see is Prime Minister in the Sanctum Sanctorum of the temple. And it's for the first time in Indian television that visuals from Muktinath are being beamed live right across India and, of course, Nepal. This is, of course, a historic moment. And this, of course, gels with the Prime Minister Narendra Modi's entire visit also, because these are the visuals. A lot of people, his domestic constituency, will be really happy to see that these visuals being for the first time, because people obviously had to trek a lot to go to this place. Muktinath is in northern Nepal, and right now today what you can see is like of course puja being done by the Prime Minister of India, but of course a visual of the deity is there in that historic temple, a temple of immense significance for both Hindus and Buddhists. But coming back to your question on China, of course China remains a worry for India, and growing Chinese closeness between Kathmandu and Beijing is something that obviously will worry India, and there has been anxieties also. China has announced its own connectivity plans, and no longer Himalayas are the barriers between Nepal and China. And China is also considering Nepal as its buffer state, so that security remains in its own restive Tibet. That's a contentious issue, and China, of course, would never like Tibet to be alienated in a sense. Territorial integrity matters a lot for China. One China policy is a policy even Donald Trump had to finally accept. Initially during his campaign he was saying something else, but later on he said okay, one China. But focus is right now on this visit, and this visit coming just a few weeks after the Prime Minister of India met the President of China in Wuhan, that historic important summit. And that plays into the entire foreign policy of the Indian Prime Minister, out-of-box thinking of the Indian Prime Minister.
Absolutely agree with you. This is the out-of-box thinking of the Indian Prime Minister. And that also states that, you know, the fact that Indian Prime Minister met Chinese President Xi Jinping just few weeks ago in Wuhan, and now he is in Nepal, which is of course now extremely close to China. That also goes on to establish the changing global equation, not just for India but across the globe.
Been the of course attempts by the Indian Prime Minister, and that attempts are also working, because that is what the Indian Prime Minister wants, a new image of India, a new India. And this, of course, what you can see is out of the box thinking by the Indian Prime Minister, because never before this has been attempted. We know hug diplomacy, we know a lot of other types of diplomacy, but this is faith diplomacy on your screens. That of course helps a lot when it comes to India and Nepal relations. relationship, a relationship based on roti, beti ka rishta, or food or family relationship. And this is the focus of the entire visit. These are great optics, very good optics, but the question is, will it translate in changing the image of India on the ground that has suffered in past few years? But there are always naysayers, and let's hope for the best between the India-Nepal ties, and hopefully after the visit there can be re-engagement and re-emphasis on this special relationship.
Siddhant, speaking of naysayers, I would actually like to ask you, how is the Nepalese media reacting to PM Modi's visit, and what is the general feel online when it comes to Indian Prime Minister's visit to Nepal?
Well, Nepalese media initially had a mixed review, and of course right now the visit is underway, so they are just reporting on what has happened, the deliverables. Mixed because after the blockade there was a mixed image of India, not positive very much, and of course not negative also, because India has been a close ally for a long time. Nepalese media has been talking about incompleted projects. They have been talking about past promises but never fulfilled, but they are also talking about how India has been a close ally, they can back on any time, a country where a lot of people from Nepal work. Though of course Twitter trend had a different version. Twitter was not very positive about the visit, but the news was of course talking about what can be the main focus, the deliverables, how India can help in various other projects, India's various earthquake reliefs which have been helping Nepal. But clearly the focus now has shifted to something else, that's called the faith diplomacy. Yesterday even we saw hug diplomacy with both the prime ministers ahead, before the press statements, having that warm hug, and after that the press statements came. But today is faith diplomacy.
Right. Thank you so much, Siddhant, for bringing us all those details live from Nepal.